So today we're going to be doing some we're going to be doing some more desensitizing with Tilly here today. And I think it's important to show you how to desensitize with fly spray. Every horse needs to have fly spray from time to time, and it can be very dangerous spraying a horse that's afraid of fly spray. Believe me, I've had my troubles with some horses, especially my horse Duff. But he's better now, so he doesn't make a very good example. Tilly has not had any fly spray. Oh, she's just checking me out. Yes, just checking me out. No chewing on the tack. I don't allow chewing on the tack. But I'm going to be putting some fly spray on her. And let me show you how I do that. Yes, good girl. And I like to use a natural fly spray by Nature's Balance Care. The reason being is this fly spray is actually a coat conditioner, but it has such a great smell to it. It has aromatherapy qualities to it. So it's a nice experience for the horse instead of toxic poisons being put on their skin. You know, the skin is the largest organ of the body and it absorbs everything applied to it. So I avoid using chemicals and poisons and insecticides. And these coat conditioners, you find that they work just as well because they have natural ingredients that are repugnant to flies and other biting insects. So I like to use this, and particularly Nature's Balance. So I'm just checking it out, see what she thinks of that. What do you think of that? If she's frightened, she would have backed off. That's why I'm so close. She's not gonna jump into me. She's gonna get away from this. So I'm just gonna spray in the air. And I want to invoke her curiosity. Curiosity replaces fear. So if I can encourage curiosity in a horse, that's going to go a lot further for me. She wants to taste it. That's going to go a lot further for me in helping her deal with any fear. So to spray her, I'm going to come right in here in the shoulder area. I'm going to shorten that lead rope so I can pull that nose around to keep her away from me if she starts to get frightened. And I'm just going to kind of spray at the feet and move away. Oh, that was scary. And I'm supporting her. You see my hand is on her neck. You're all right. Just give her a little bit of spray and then retreat. So a little bit of spray and retreat. Now this is a good example of what happens. I bump her, ask her to stop. I'm gonna come in here and help her. It's all right. It's all right. I'm gonna spray a little bit. I'm pulling her nose to me. Each time I spray, I pull that nose because that makes her bottom go away so she doesn't kick out at it. It's okay. It's all right. I'm gonna spray a little bit. Good girl. Tell her she's a good girl. It's not gonna hurt. Good girl, you're doing just fine. Let me love you for that. Come in here and appreciate her and love her on the neck. She's licking and chewing. Good. You notice that licking and chewing? Good. There. Good girl. I sprayed and she didn't move. So I'm just going to love her for that. Let her know. Oh, she took a nice breath. Let her know that's what I want. I don't want you to move when I spray. Good. Spray your back. Good. You know she's flinching, but she's not moving. Good girl. Loving her through it, supporting her through it. I'm rubbing her the whole time. Good girl. My hand is just rubbing her, encouraging her that you're all right. I'm just supporting her through it. Good. Good girl. She's finding out, you know what? This stuff doesn't burn. It doesn't hurt my nose. It doesn't sting. Good girl.